Tim Gobble, and thank you for watching BCSO TV. With summer fast approaching, many folks are going to be out on the river. We're out today on the Hiawassee River getting our boat ready for the summer season. I want to highlight the Bradley County Sheriff's Office Marine Unit. It's led by Lieutenant Buck Campbell, and also Jamie Thurman is part of our Marine Unit, and they're going to be out on Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays periodically through the season, helping to promote boating safety. Buck and Jamie, thank you all for being here, and thank you for what you've done in the past and continue to do for boating safety. I also have Chief Dyer with us today. Buck, tell us a little bit about our Marine Unit and some of its background and some of the things we'd like to see in the future.
The Marine Unit started probably 5 to 6 years ago with donated boats and motor and stuff. And this boat here was donated, and the motor was donated, so it's at a very low cost to the citizens of Bradley County. And several years ago, we noticed an increase volume of traffic on the Hiawassee here.
Now that's because Bradley County's growing.
Bradley County's a very growing, progressive community. And one of the areas we want to concentrate on, especially for our younger population, was with these recreational vehicles in the water, because we started seeing a lot more increase of injuries. National statistics was showing people was getting injured. There was some laws put into place that you had to be so old now to drive some of these things. And so with the donations from the community and citizens, we thought it was just a good thing to be out here and be proactive and to educate, so we wouldn't have any of the devastation. It's either education or devastation.
Well, I appreciate that and the work that you guys do. Jamie, you're certified in boating by the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency, and you are out here on a regular basis throughout the summer. Tell us a little bit about some of your duties and some of the things that you've encountered and anything else that you think our viewers might be need to be aware of.
One of the things we do is get to know the population of people that's around here, different boaters and landowners and houses and stuff, get to know them, because we patrol the areas from the water also. That way we can see the backside of the houses that patrol cars can't normally see. We're the first to respond because of we're already on the water. If there's any water accidents, such as drownings or somebody gets hurt, medical conditions and stuff. We also work special events and stuff that's held at marinas and stuff. We also, we do a lot of things on the water that people don't even really think about, such as we do safety checks. If we see somebody, we can write tickets and stuff if there's a problem with, you know, say children not in life jackets, as well as people doing dangerous things. A lot of things is just the fact of ignorance, I believe, not knowing the laws and how to govern by the operating boat.
I want to come back to some boating safety tips in just a minute. But first, Chief, do you have anything you'd like to add? I know you and I get a lot of phone calls at the sheriff's office, and many people are very appreciative of our deputies being on the water and how they protect the community and keep things from being stolen off these docks and other things.
Right, this gave us a presence on the river that we just never had before, and it's come in handy several times. I know they've even found stranded boaters out here that needed to tow in, and they've been able to assist them back into the shore. It's just give us a presence out here, not only for watching people's property, but also with any illegal drug activity that might be going on in the river. Plus, with Homeland Security, we have the ability to watch Bowater and Olin Chemical Companies and provide an extra presence on the river.
Well, that's good. And let's tell our viewers just a little bit, Jamie, some boating safety tips. Of course, number one, drinking and boating don't mix, just like drinking and driving don't mix. And we want to encourage people to go out on the river, have a good time, but be very careful and don't get intoxicated, because that is what typically results in accidents happening, and crashes on boats can be life-threatening and very dangerous, just like car crashes, can't they, Jamie?
Yes, sir. With boat speeds and stuff, a lot of boats and jet skis can go 70, 80 miles per hour with no brakes on a boat. When if you've been intoxicated and your reflexes are slowed down, that could cause you to have a whole lot more damage than in the sense of a car crash even.
So our recommendation is do not boat and drink at the same time. Also, it's important to have personal flotation devices for each person on the boat.
Yes, sir.
That's required?
Yes, sir. That and fire extinguishers. And there's complete guidelines you can get at most marinas, as well as any of the wildlife agencies' websites, and probably be on ours shortly. A post of the regulations and stuff that you have to have for a boat before it's legally operated. Through it, and make sure your children, you know, wear life jackets. That's required. That, you know, if children underage and stuff have to have life jackets, and there's boat and safety courses that they have to take also before they can operate a boat.
I think that's important, because I think a lot of folks don't take seriously the regulations that go with boats. Or just like you have regulations with automobiles, you have regulations with boating safety too. And they'll become familiar with the rules and regulations with boats, they will be a safer boater.
And these regulations aren't designed to make people not have a good time, but they are designed to make people have a good time and a safe time, and that's what we want to encourage as well. Bug, do you have anything you'd like to add before we close?
Just one thing, just remember, as the sheriff mentioned earlier, drinking and driving a boat does not mix. And if you do drink and you drive a boat and you have an accident, you do not have the choice whether you take a blood alcohol test or not. It is given, it is mandatory through the boating things. Where a car, you may have the option, and boats, you do not. We will draw blood from you in a boating accident automatically.
Thank you, Buck, and we appreciate our viewers. Thank you for watching BCSO TV. We want to encourage everyone to enjoy the summer, have a safe summer, and thank you for watching BCSO TV. When we say protect and serve, we mean it.